Buildings make up 90% of Smith's energy footprint, which includes heating, cooling, and electricity. Currently, we burn natural gas and purchase electricity from the grid. The geothermal project will electrify our heating and cooling loads and provide cooling to all campus housing. Smith broke ground in spring of 2022, and the project is set to wrap up in 2028. Once complete, the geothermal energy system will reduce Smith's carbon emissions by 90%, reduce consumption of water by more than 10%, and improve local air quality. This project is happening in three phases, the first including housing and offices north of Elm Street, the second including the quad, and the third including academic buildings and central campus housing. Each phase area has its own well field and energy center. In geothermal heating and cooling, the ground acts as a thermal battery where heat is taken out of the ground in the winter and put back into the ground during the summer. Water is pumped in a closed loop through the wells, which are each U-shaped pipes running hundreds of feet into the ground. The water is then transported to the local energy center, where it exchanges heat with a heat pump to either heat or cool the campus. The heat pump runs on electricity, which provides the additional energy needed to get the water that circulates through our buildings to a comfortable temperature. With the geothermal project, we reduce the amount of energy needed to heat and cool the campus, but increase our electrical load. To go carbon neutral, Smith needs to stop relying on fossil fuels for our electricity. We're doing this by engaging in renewable power purchase agreements, like Farmington Solar, which currently supplies 30% of our electricity. These, in tandem with the geothermal project, will eliminate the 90% of our carbon emissions that come from our buildings and will help us reach carbon neutrality by 2030.